decked beast from higher sphere delivered. We beg of thee to dance and cavort. Dance and cavort. Cleanse all that thou wilt. Cruelty, woe, and those who plague the tower. Cleanse away the strumpet's vile progeny. Welcome, O glorious sculpted keeper. Thou art kind indeed to this aged crone. Pardon me, my dear. Where are my manners? Surely thou must hunger, O sculpted keeper. I prithee, partake of this modest dish. 'Tis only plain fare, but suck to the lees. And it will shouldst thou be by hunger's pang, thou art sure. No.
bad dream, Yuri. Put that rotten thing out of your mind. That tangled mess can't hurt you.
Oh, there you are. The exalted timbre of the bell has reached these ears of mine. Gracious, the starry sky is wondrous tonight indeed. Only your fate shines brighter. Now, these are for you. Think nothing of it. I have made my decision to be of help. May the gleaming stars guide you. I fear that you have borne witness to the whole of it. The conceits, the hypocrisy of the world built upon the Erdtree. The follies of men, their bitter suffering. Is there no hope for redemption? The answer, sadly, is clear. There never was any hope. They were each of them defective, unhinged from the start. Marika herself, and the fingers that guided her. And this is what troubles me. No matter our efforts, if the roots are rotten, then we have little recourse. Ever young Mikola saw things for what they were. He knew that his bloodline was tainted, his roots mired in madness. A tragedy if ever there was one. That he would feel compelled to renounce everything. When the blame lay squarely with the mother. May the gleaming stars guide you evermore.